An ammonia isotank for electronics applications is a specifically designed unit with a glycol heating system for higher flow gas supply, and its frame is of specific dimension for transportation requirements. Ammonia isotank inspection is essential for safe operation and quality assurance. In this video, we will demonstrate how to inspect the ammonia isotank. While performing the ammonia isotank inspection, proper PPE should be worn, including safety shoes, work jacket, gloves, and a full-face respirator for conducting a leak check. In Linde, there is a standardized ammonia ISO traveler checklist to guide personnel to do an inspection. It is kept inside the document holder, which is mounted to the tank frame. The inspector should open the cap of the document holder and check that the traveler checklist and the COA are supplied, and that there is no moisture in the holder. The ISO tank number should be the same as shown in the COA. The concentration of ammonia and all impurities should be in the specification. The next step is to check the tank body and the frame condition. First, make sure that the ISO tank is wedged by chocks. There should be no dents, bends, or rust on the tank body. Ensure that tank labels and the paint on the tank are in good condition. Also, make sure that it is easy to read the labels, that there are no scratches, and that old labels are removed. Confirm that the four chassis pins are fully engaged and locked, and the tires are in good condition and have no wear. Make certain that a safety approval plate by the International Convention for Safety Containers, or CSC, is mounted on the ISO frame. The next step is to check the rear manifold box. A leak check should be done before opening the cover. Slowly move the gas detector probe around the periphery of the cover, as well as the lock pin hole. Verify that a customs clearance has already been done for this ISO tank, then cut off the customs seal. Open the rear door and engage the lock pin. Check for leaks of the main gas and the gas and liquid valves and the flanges. Verify that the manifold valves are in good condition and that the main gas and liquid valves are closed. Make sure the flange and cap are installed on the liquid valve and the flange bleed valve is closed. Verify that the vapor bypass and the pneumatic valves are closed. Confirm that the level gauge is in good condition and the temperature and the pressure gauge are in good condition. Record those values on the traveler checklist. Check the condition of the emergency cable, spring, and copper connector, and ensure that they are not frayed, bent, or broken. Open the outlet cap of the 1-inch FVCR connection. Remove the gasket. Then verify the outlet connection is clean and free from scratches or cuts. Clean the connection with a clean cloth if it is required. Check the gasket seal surface. If it is clean and free from scratches, reinstall the gasket with a retainer. If there are some scratches on the seal surface, replace it with a new gasket, then reinstall the outlet cap. Close the box cover and hook the lock pin in the right place. Install the seal to secure the rear door. And record the seal number. While inspecting the top side of the ISO tank, a proper height ladder should be used. Personnel should wear an approved safety harness and a suitable connector. If the anchor point is larger than the hook of the harness, use a self-locking connector. Then conduct a leak check before opening the manhole cover door. Cut off the lock and open the door. Verify that anti-tamper straps are in place on the bolts for the manhole cover, relief valve, and vent valves. Confirm that the relief valve is in good condition and the gauge reading is zero. Validate that the heater vent valves are closed, there is no piping damage, and that end plugs are in place and tightly installed. The next step is to inspect the heating system. First, confirm that the heating control system is in good condition, all the covers are in place, glasses are unbroken, and that there is no fault LED on. The heater electric cables and wires should be in good condition. Make sure that the grounding cable is attached tightly and not damaged, and that the grounding lug is not damaged. The heater wires should be all contained within the cable tray, and the restraints for the cables should be in place. The inlet and outlet valves of the heater should be open, drain valves closed, and the plugs installed. Make sure that the glycol inlet valves are open. The level of the heating media glycol should be within the minimum and maximum limit. Make sure that the temperature connector is in place and not damaged. After finishing the inspection, check off the items in the ISO Traveler checklist and put the documents and the new gaskets back into the document holder. After that, attach the three-layer labels if the supplier did not do that. Also attach the IQC-approved or OQC-approved labels and write down the inspection date. To summarize, in this video, we have learned that proper PPE should be worn for ammonia ISO tank inspection. The appearance of the tank should be in good condition. A leak check should be done before opening the valve box. All the valves, gauges, and emergency system in the valve box should be in good condition. The level of glycol should be within limits, and the heating unit should be in good condition.